We are live! I know every word. Detective Ben said, Daddy Miss Noah down, someone down the lane. We are live! It is Wednesday night. We are drinking today. What a show! What a show! We're meeting a two-day-old new mom who dis baby. If you watched last week, you know who I'm talking about. We are also playing the world's first ever rousing edition of Is Your Child a Psychopath? It's a game show I invented based on my own personal experience, and Evan is going to be awarding a prestigious award comment of the episode. So jump in the comments. Heather Powell says food. Samantha says hi. Ladies and gentlemen, do you know how I feel about today's live episode? It's food! It's no big deal. It's just a custom tie-dye hoodie that says our new catchphrase. It's food. So in case you are tuning in and you missed last week's episode and you're like, what is food? Well, I'll tell you, last week, Evan misinterpreted one of your comments in what turned out to be a legendary moment. Take a look. Are you laughing at Avalon?
I've never in my whole life heard that expression.
What?
It's food?
I think she meant to say it's good.
Oh, I'm going to use the expression, it's food.
I mean, that picture like, you sent me from Love Island
that
is
you
food.
Like, you go, oh man, did you see that game yesterday? It was food.
It's food. Avalon, I believe you meant to say it's good, but please confirm in the comments. But for the record, for the rest of this episode, we're going to use it's food. It's food! Okay, so Christine is back up in the comments. Everybody
Avalon was the OG.
Sorry. Avalon, if you're out there, please jump in the comments. Everyone was using It's Food last week, including Evan and I. All week long, we've been saying It's Food. And you know what? When the world is burning, it's nice to stop and take a moment and just say, It's Food!
It's taking the house by storm.
It's taking the house by storm. Not to mention that you're up in my Instagram comments. You're DMing me. It's food is happening, ladies and gentlemen. And we realized last week while we were using the expression that we could monetize it. Take a look. This amount of cuteness is food.
Let's make merch.
Next week, I'll be selling tie-dye sweatshirts that say, it's food. Would I lie to you? Would I lie to this beloved community? No, I have a custom, one of one, it's food, cropped hooded sweatshirt. Ladies and gentlemen, if this isn't food, I don't know what is. Do you know what was not food? The expression on the face of the gentleman who made my custom tie-dye it's food sweatshirt.
Excuse me, ma'am. Could you spell that again?
It was like IT apostrophe S food exclamation point. Yes, it's food. So unfortunately, I am not selling these.
Yes.
It's not yet. If you want to make an offer on this one of one it's food sweatshirt, in the comments, tell me what you would offer for this sweatshirt. I will donate it all to charity and then personally send you my sweaty It's Food sweater. Food, food, food. And ladies and gentlemen, it is food, isn't it? It really is. So welcome. This is going to be a really food episode. trying to just work it in organically.
All right, we're approaching the edge. We're approaching the line.
Evan is here, ladies and gentlemen. He still working on Love Island, still spending his days toiling away looking at young women in string bikinis while his lovely wife sits at home in an It's Food sweatshirt. Also sexy. You're so tired. I mean, he's working crazy hours. The other day he was sitting on the floor and I was talking to him. We were like talking about ordering windows and doors and he fell asleep on the floor just fast asleep. Yeah, so
4 p.m.
He's at his breaking point. Are you going to appear on camera today or just mysteriously lurk on the microphone? Oh, are you going to grace us with your presence? Wow. That was not a food shot. The shot was very pixelated, but you look better the more pixelated you are. So
I don't feel like food.
Okay, thank you very much. So Evan and I, life update, quick life update, and then we're going to meet our two-day-old baby, and you're all going to weep alongside me. Life update, we're doing construction in our backyard. Because if this pandemic has taught us anything, it's that our house is not big enough for four people to be trapped inside of. Tell me in the comments if you felt the same way. Like, unless you're living in a Calabasas estate, I think we all had that feeling. Like, suddenly you're like, what? We're working here. We're living here. Our kids are here. There's no respite. I am currently sitting in my office, which is also, as you can see from Evan's shot, my closet. And this is the only space we have that is not like overrun with children. And as you recall, I told you that one time I came out of the shower to go get dressed nude and Evan was sitting on a work Zoom call. So we don't want that to happen again. We are turning our garage and like building it into a full office guest house so that we can work there, also so that we can lure the grandmas out to help us raise our children. It's desperation at this point. And if I have an in-law here in the house, it's not gonna be food. So we need to lure the in-laws with like their own space so that they'll come and stay for an extended period and help us with our children. You feel me, right?
Come have a 3-week cup of coffee.
Please.
Hold on, quick shout out.
Lucky Bromhead, my makeup artist / Emmy nominated Schitt's Creek makeup artist, Lucky Bromhead. Hey, Luck, I did my own makeup today because we live in different countries. I tried to pull some of the orange tones from the It's Food sweatshirt. I hope that you appreciate it. So yeah, that's what's going on in our backyard. I don't know anything about construction. I know a lot of you have done construction. If you have any advice, please throw it in the comments. I'm desperate for it. Evan is at work all day, so I'm the one dealing like with the water main, and like half the time I'm just Googling what things are. The only thing I know how to do on a construction site is aggressively pose on a construction site. Here's exhibit A, B, and C.
Ooh.
I posted these photos and I got many people in the comments saying, who takes these pictures? The answer, ladies and gentlemen, is Evan, who is, I'm going to say, the worst Instagram husband that has ever walked the face of the planet.
Oh, excuse me.
Evan.
Exhibit A.
That is not. Listen, let me tell you. I often think like, God, I wish I had Jillian Harris's husband or like Coco Roche's or some of these husbands who like live to take the Instagram. Oh, that was just Evan cracking a beer. If you're wondering what that disruptive sound was. Just have a sip of my vodka cream. If I ask Evan to take an Instagram photo for me, he will take it. He will sigh. He will grunt. The level of enthusiasm on a scale of 1 to 10 is below a 0. It's a negative level of enthusiasm. Sometimes I'll say, can you take an Instagram photo? And he will take one photo, which, let's be honest, is a crime against humanity. Because when I ask you to take an Instagram photo, I'm really asking you to take 87 photos at all different angles. Try portrait, try regular, do some bursts. I need to find one where I look adequate. And you're incapable of doing that. Is that correct?
I vehemently disagree.
What?
I mean, if you look at your Instagram feed, which is very popular and entertaining, I'm responsible for at least 60 to 70% of the content on there. So however my methods go down, it results in good stuff.
Listen, Woody Allen was responsible for a lot of films, but he wasn't doing great things while making them. At least he can take good photos, says Messiah. Does he? He's so lazy. He's so unhappy to be there. Ugh. Can you just, Lucky, who is in a relation I'm so excited about. Hi, Luck. My dude takes the worst photos of me, worse than an unexpected front-facing camera from a low angle. Like, I might as well do it myself at that point. Tell me in the comments, does your partner take good photos? And here's another element to the Instagram husband. Sia says, I always, can't even get one. Karina, I'm with you. I always say when I die, my child will have 100% memories of father due to my epic iPhone skills. Thank you. Can I get a slow clap for Messiah? This was my second point for all the moms out there. My camera rule is photos of my children and photos of Evan with my children. God forbid I'm doing something cute with my kids. I look cute with my kids. There is no fucking way he is going to take a picture of it. The only memories our children will have will be with you because I take the pictures. You don't take any cute pictures with the children.
Pretty good work.
Okay, there we go. So we're doing construction and tell me what you think of it. I also want to say, just because Lucky is here, before we get to our very special guest, because Lucky is here, I want to congratulate Lucky on her Emmy nomination, and I just need like a mega air horn moment for Schitt's Creek, for Dan Levy, for truly, I know you all felt this, throw this in the comments, but like this, it was just a incredible night and an incredible like Canadian pride moment. But beyond that, I had this like, I just felt, and I felt this way about you, Lucky, and your nomination, because you know you're clearly the best makeup artist on planet Earth if you can make this appropriate for television. But like with Dan, just watching him, that's somebody that I have grown up with. We have known each other since we were literally 22, both out of school, didn't know what we were doing. We've kind of grown up together. We went through so many big things together. He was, you know, we were best friends when Evan and I started dating. Like, he's been there for everything. He was a best man at my wedding. So to watch him, someone that I know so well, like experience such joy on such a major plot, like stage, was truly like, I felt it in every bone of my body. Like, I just felt so happy. And I realized in that moment that we have so few opportunities to just experience our friends and our families and the people close to us is like pure moments of joy. And I realized, like, I wish I could be in all of your hospital rooms as you all birth your children, because like, it's truly, you only have a handful of those moments in your entire life where you are experiencing, or your friends are experiencing that true pure joy. And for me, watching Dan in that moment was like getting to witness, I mean, It was like witnessing the birth of a child. It was really, truly amazing. So congratulations to Dan. Lucky says, all of our masks were full of snot from joy crying. So was mine. Not a mask, but still like so much joy crying, so much pure joy. It was really so special. So speaking of pure joy and experiencing other people's joys and like taking a moment to just relish in it, last week, I showed some of my favorite bump and baby photos. This was one that I really emphasized. This is Laura Duckett. She posted this photos when she was 4 centimeters dilated. So on the show, I was like, well, surely she's had the baby and congratulations to her. And then this happened last week. Take a look. Wait, go back. Laura? That was Laura of the photo.
Laura,
you're still fucking pregnant? Laura, you were 4 centimeters dilated here. I swear to God, I birthed my twins at 4 centimeters. Laura, I've been dying to know what's going on with you, because the baby bump is like so unreal. You are still fucking pregnant? Holy shit. It is literal food. Ladies and gentlemen, after that moment, I told Laura that I wanted to have her on this week's show. And because this is a community and you are my mom friends, Laura and her 2-day-old baby are here live.
Look at
Hi, Laura.
Hello.
Laura.
This is Layla.
Hi, Layla. Layla is literally 48 hours old.
I'm trying to keep her in the screen, but keep her head up also. I just want to say, though, the first thing, Lucky, if you want any tips on my makeup routine, you can get Jesse's my contact info from Jesse.
Yeah, perfect. You have a lot on. She's probably going to want to peel it back and give you more natural.
A little more natural, yeah.
Laura, everyone is freaking out. I don't know if you're seeing the comments.
Yes, but I am. Thank you, everybody.
That baby was inside you 2 days ago. We saw basically the shape of the baby's head in this photo.
Pretty much, yeah. Yeah.
And she's here. She's here. So this is Layla.
Layla Grace.
Layla Grace, that's so beautiful. I have to tell you, I had like a super hot babysitter in the 90s named Layla. She was like, had like all the pleats in her guest jeans. She was so beautiful. And I always thought Layla is the most beautiful name ever since I was a little girl. It really is.
It's my husband's grandmother's name also. So it's nice to have the family connection there.
Oh, the best. Okay, so Laura DM'd me from her sitz bath. And I just want to say, that's the kind of intimacy I want and expect from this new mom who this community. You DM'd me a day ago after you had had Layla, and you told me a little bit, but I'd like to hear a little more about your birth experience. Laura?
Yeah, so it was fast and furious. Like you said, and like I said last week, I was 4 centimeters dilated for like a week and a half or 2 weeks. I had the 2 membrane sweeps. Nothing worked. We tried everything to get her to come on her own, and didn't happen. So Monday I went in for an induction and I was like, okay, don't give me the Pitocin. Just break my water and let's see what happens. Cause like, I think we're ready to go. So the doctor broke my water at 8:30 in the morning and she was born by 10:45 and it was a whirlwind. And at 7 centimeters, I was like, okay, I need the epidural. And the nurse was like, epidural now. She was yelling at the anesthesiologist. He's like, I'll be there in 10 minutes. She's like, we don't have 10 minutes. Get here now. So anyways, epidural didn't really work. I got it, but it wasn't fully effective. So it wasn't the greatest birth experience, but it was fine. But Layla was face down at up, down. I never know which way they're supposed to be. Her head was down, but her face was not the way it was supposed to be, like up versus down. I think it's down. Anyways, my husband's an expert apparently. And her heart rate was dropping and she wasn't coming out. So the doctor was like, I need to use forceps. And I was like, oh, like, what's the risk? And she's like, for the baby, there's not really a risk, but for you, you're likely going to tear like to your anal sphincter. And I was like, great. So anyways, we had to do it. So she used forceps and I tore and, yeah. Shitting is quite the experience now.
Do we have an air horn? We have a round of applause.
Yeah. If I could get that every time I successfully shit, that would be great because it feels like an accomplishment.
Tell your husband, I know he's standing right behind the camera. Tell him to get an applause, generic applause sound effect on his iPhone. And he should be ready to play it every time. Just a little drop comes out.
Well, I was I was texting with my mom when I was shitting this morning. And I was like, Mom, I'm just texting you just to get, you know, the pain off my mind. And then I was like, I heard a sploosh. And she's like, good job, sweetie. I'm so proud of you.
Okay. Laura.
Good old days.
First of all, when you said anal sphincter, I like felt it in my anal sphincter. It really clenched back there for me. We all feel you. And I want everyone to get your fingers on your poop emojis in the comments because tell us if you had a similar shit-related issue. And I'm going to say something. You're bringing out the deepest, most personal.
Who cares?
I don't think we've ever talked about this.
Honestly, people need to know like what happens. It's not all like cuteness, like, oh, she's so cute. Yeah, well, guess what she did to my body? And, you know, my boobs.
nobody tells you about the afterbirth.
Yeah.
So I had, I would say my birth of two vaginally was worse than the after, like, for me, that was easier, sorry, to birth two babies than to take a shit. For like, and it was so psychologically traumatizing for me that I could not properly poo. There were moments where at like 2 a.m, I was sitting in the bathroom screaming with a plastic bag on my hand, like trying to dig. I don't know what I had lost, like poop issues got to me and I
the
lost
screaming
it.
From the bathroom was legit scary. Yeah. You mean from the delivery birth. Room?
Oh, yeah.
Legit. I believe it.
It was much harder to take a shit than to birth two children. That's what I'll say. And you could quote me on that. I hope, you know, on my gravestone that's, it's just, it was harder to take a shit than to birth two children, Jesse Cruikshank.
Yeah.
Miss Lee says, amen, third degree tear, episiotomy. Oh, so how's your walking, Laura? Are you like?
Oh, we went for our first family walk today. You know, the big brother, I have a son, he's almost 3 and he just wants to do everything with her, which is adorable. But he's high energy. So we said, okay, let's go for a walk. And as we're walking, I'm like, this is going to be a short walk. I'm trailing behind them. You know, my 3-year-old and my soup, like my husband is just, we're complete opposites. He's just like laid back, very slow paced. I've never, ever walked behind him. And I'm there like, guys, slow down. Mama needs to, you know, make sure her parts are staying in. So, yeah, but we went for a walk around the block slowly.
Mama doesn't really
got some fresh air.
Sphincter on the sidewalk of
nobody wants that. Yeah. Yeah.
Wow. Okay. I had an emergency C-section and didn't poop for a week. When I finally did, I was so proud and named it Ocean. You named the poop Ocean, Allison? Were you baby after the poop? It's no one tells you. I remember people said like you might poop during.
Oh, yeah.
And I was like, well, that's not romantic. I want like to be wearing a cute robe. And little did I know there was nothing cute. Did you poop during the delivery?
I think I might have, but worse than that is she pooped. So she pooped in utero. So there's some meconium, which is not the greatest, but everything was fine. But not only that, she pooped like must have been seconds after she got out of me. There was shit all over both of us. My husband was like, it's there. It's there. The nurse was like, wiping. I think even she was disgusted. There was poop. I had poop on my mask somehow.
Oh, right. You had to wear a mask.
Yeah, I had to wear a mask too. That wasn't that bad.
Well,
I was worried about like pushing with the mask and everything. Yeah. I would have had poop in my mouth. The mask saved me.
You know, gosh, there's one positive. Wear a mask, everybody.
Yeah.
If anything, it will prevent poop from getting in your mouth.
Yeah.
Laura, you are a literal hero. Where can your husband at least, we want to know that he's taking care of you, that he's appreciating you.
He's coming. He's going to poke his
head. He's going to make an appearance. Oh, congratulations.
Good job, Kip.
You worked hard.
You know what? Just to be there, handling the poop, understanding the poop, that's a real man right there. And father. So congratulations, guys.
And there's our friend Stacy.
Oh, hi Mike.
Hey, Mike. Oh yeah, that's Mike.
Hi Mike. Mike,
and actually, so Stacy, Mike is my soccer coach. That's how we met. So actually when I was in labor and delivery, he had his Coach Mike hoodie on, and every doctor and nurse was like, oh, you play soccer? He's like, no, I coach. That's how we met. That's another one of these are all my friends.
That's exactly my impression.
Andrea is she's my best friend, and our firstborns are 4 months apart, and she's due in 3 weeks. Anyway, so all these girls that just commented, they're all part of our soccer team.
Oh, wow. I love it. The baby is 2 days old for the person who just asked, just tuning in. Coach Mike, I'm going to call you that forever. And Laura, congratulations.
Thank you.
A soccer player, I assume, Layla. Can we get one?
He has to be. Cobras, huh?
She's so cute.
Don't you want another one? Oh, my gosh. Wow.
Andrea's still fucking pregnant.
brings it full circle. Laura, thank you so much for jumping in the comments, for sharing.
Thank you for having us.
And for being on this live and being a part of this new mom of this community. And to Layla, the newest member of our new mom of this community.
Well, can I make a request for the next live appearance?
Yes.
Dan Levy.
Oh, okay.
Mm. We'll get it.
If we can get
two room in the frame for all those statues.
Come on. If you can get Laura Duckett from Montreal, you can get a fellow Canadian
from the West Island.
From the West Island, yeah.
Till the end of time,
I'll see what I can do.
You can say, oh, you're not available? I literally had a mom come on my show.
2 days.
2 days after.
48 hours left of giving birth. So what's yours?
Come on, Dan.
She had an anal sphincter tear, okay? You can put your Emmys away and come on the show. Thank you, Laura. Good
Thank
luck.
Thank you so much. Bye.
Oh, my gosh. Guys, a two-day-old baby. This is what I love about this fam. If you want to come on the show, just slide up into my DM while in a sitz bath. You know, let me know. I'll let you on. Please, that's what this is for. Like, you're a part of this as much as I am, as much as he is, as much as this It's Food sweatshirt is. All right. Last but not least, here's, you know, what's going on in our home. We are having some, how would you describe them, Evan? Behavioral issues?
Yeah.
Challenges, behavioral challenges with our three-year-olds, to the point where last week, around like Thursday or Friday, I was like weeping to you saying I'm so out of control. I don't know how to handle it. I don't know what I'm doing wrong. And so instead of asking an expert, I thought I would ask you, just my community of internet mom friends, if my child is a psychopath with a rousing addition of... Is your child a psychopath? This game has never been played before in the history of time, and so we have no idea how it's going to go, but here are the rules. I will tell you one thing that my child may or may not have done in the last 2 weeks. You have to get in the comments as fast as you can to say, yes, your child has done it, no, never, or your child has done something similar or hopefully worse, because I want to feel better about myself here. All right. So here is question number one. Has your child kicked you in the face because he did not want a nap? Or because he didn't want to eat his lunch? Because he didn't want you to take away his toy? Has your child kicked you in the face? Just a simple yes, no. Has they kicked you elsewhere? We talked about the testicle cancer reveal last week. Tell me in the comments. Stephanie says no. Well, okay, great. Becky says yes, and she clearly wrote fast because the yes is capitalized. Okay, great. Oh, yes, an overwhelming yes. I love it. Headbutts do count, Amy. We will accept headbutts. Yes, you're all winning the game so far. Yeah, car seat. That's a good one.
Oh!
All right, ripped my hair out, says Karina. Yeah, it happens. It happens. Question number two, has your child dumped every toy basket out onto the floor? Maliciously. I'm going to add, well, they're not playing and having fun, and so they accidentally dump it. They actively go and take every basket and dump it upside down, not in one area, all over the living room, hallway, kitchen, all over the house. Melissa says yes. Thank you. 100%, absolutely, every time. Guys, like, is it ever possible to have a nice house, to have a clean house, or are there just going to be Mr. Potato Head parts lying around that I will one day kill myself on? Katrina says this morning, yeah, they're relentless with the toy thing. Yeah, Lindsay, okay. 100 Lego pieces while I receive the death stare. That's the worst. You know what's the worst? This is the worst. It's the like doing shit with the death stare, knowing they shouldn't be doing it. Okay, question number two. So far, you're all passing. Has your child knocked a brand new 27-inch computer monitor onto the ground, shattering it?
Yes.
Just gonna pan over. Pardon the mess. That's RIP. RIP this brand new computer monitor, which was torn to the ground. Shattered in many pieces by our child. So that's, yeah, I answered that one. Okay, next question. has your child looked you in the eye and drawn on your sofa? I would accept drawn on your wall, floor, looked you in the eye. Take the crayon, draw on something that they know they should not be drawing on while looking me in the eye, and then tell me to clean it up. No!
The audacity!
The audacity, Chelsea!
The terrorist!
It is not okay. Okay, next. I'm feeling really a lot better about our own children. Has your child ever decapitated a toy? Specifically, 2 Buzz Lightyears, 3 Woodies, 1 Jessie. In the span of about 3 weeks. Has your child ever decapitated? I'm talking, I don't want, an arm can come off, a hand can come off, a foot, a head. Taken a head off of a toy. Tell me in the comments. Because my children have done it many times. And they don't care if the toy then just exists without a head. They do it anyway. Christine says very slowly while smiling at me. Yes, LOL dolls and naked all the time. Naked all the time. I don't mind naked, but yes, and tried to put on another toy. The head switching. You know, mine waterboarded is funny. You guys, what the fuck is wrong with our kids? What is this? Next question. Has your child pulled an open jug of cranberry juice off the kitchen counter while you weren't looking, maybe even while you were making this cocktail for tonight's live? Do you have a kitchen currently covered in sticky cranberry juice? Just tell me in the comments. Has your child ever poured something? This morning, my child took his cup of milk, looked me in the eye, poured it on the floor. Heather says they're all psychos. She's like, they're all psychos. I put a little extra vodka in this after that happened. Okay, I think this is our last question. Has your child ever thrown a wine glass, second to last question, thrown a wine glass into the kitchen sink, breaking it, and several other dishes? This happened 2 days ago. Took a wine glass, chucked it in the kitchen sink while I was lifting him up to wash his hands, shattered all the dishes. And I don't know what to say. I don't know how to do. I don't know. I can't take his wine glass away because then we'd have a bigger problem. Lisa says yes.
Lisa is going through it.
Lisa, we're in this together, okay? This is a real thing. Last but not least, again, toy related. Has your child ever dipped their fist in Vaseline? Full fist. And then rubbed it on the wall to clean it. Rubbed it on the white wall just to.
This seems clean like it. A very specific question.
Very specific. Have they dipped their fist in Vaseline? Rubbed it on the wall. I would accept, like, eating something and sticky, then rubbed it on the wall. Ella Mayo says, Lisa, yes.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. No hesitation. Oh, yeah. Guys. 3 is a hot MFing mess.
Lisa!
Vicks Vapor Rub today! Oh, Lisa, that has that. It's got those vapors in it. Pseudo cream on gray walls. Oh, Aaron rubbed it all over himself. Oh, ladies and gentlemen, congratulations. That is how you play. Is my child a psychopath? Amy had poop in her walls. And I think the answer that we were looking for is yes. Yes, but doesn't it feel a little bit better to know that we're not alone? Like, I have had moments where I'm like, is it just my kids? Is it just my kids? Or does anyone else do this? And so it's really nice to know that all your kids do it. Samantha Clark says, get Lisa a drink. For real. Lisa is going through it, Samantha. Ladies and gentlemen, we're all going through it, but you know what? It makes it a little bit better. I slurred my words there. It's the cranberry vod. Makes it a little bit better when we're going through it together. Because when you go through hardship together, do you know what that is, ladies and gentlemen? It's food! Ooh. On a honestly. And if you have real tips on like how to deal with any of those things, please feel free to drop them in my comments, in the DMs, any of it, because I need help to deal. And weeping to Evan at the end of a long day is not the best coping mechanism, nor is a cranberry vodka. But here we are. Ladies and gentlemen, do we have a comment of the episode?
Man, I think it's this one.
Are you going to award?
It's representative of many comments before it. I think it's this.
Okay. Congratulations, Samantha Clark! Comment of the episode, get Lisa a drink. You know what? Lisa answered yes to every single thing on that list. She needs a drink, and Samantha, you pointed it out. Congratulations, you win. Comment of that. There's no prize. Did anybody bid on my It's Food sweatshirt?
We got a $50 bid, not nearly enough.
$50? I did pay more to have it custom made, but I would take it. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much. It's food! I hope your weeks are super food. I hope you all subscribe to the YouTube channel if you haven't already. Search New Mom Who Dis on YouTube. Click subscribe. You know all the food shit goes down on YouTube anyway, right? Isn't that what the kids say? Huge shout out to Laura, to Coach Mike, to Baby Layla, to Lucky Bromhead, to all of you for being here with us tonight. I can't wait to see you next Wednesday. It's going to be so food. Oh, $50 Canadian. Stephanie, I definitely paid more to have this made, so I'm going to have to reconsider the offer. All right. Thank you, everybody. Have the best night. Mwah, mwah, mwah.
Hush, my darling, don't fear, my darling. The lion sleeps tonight.